Alright guys, welcome back, it's GD, and today we're going to continue what we ended last episode. Let's just start. Load game. Okay. Okay, well, who should I choose my poem next? Okay, next. Yuri. Okay. Yuri stares at the poem. Still time to her and finish reading. Oh, sorry, I forgot to start speaking. It's fine, don't force yourself. I'm not. I just need to put my thoughts into words. Hold on, okay. This is your first time reading poem, right? Writing a poem, right? Yeah. Why do you ask? I'm just making sure. I guess it might be after reading thought. So it's that bad? No. Did I just change my voice? I'm sorry. Yuri buries her face in her hands. What the fuck? I couldn't help but notice it when. It's been several minutes and we really haven't gone anywhere. It might take Yuri a while to get used to new people. It's fine, I really didn't notice. What were you saying? Right, it's just that there are specific writing habits that are usually typical of new writers. And been through that myself. And I think the most noticeable thing I recognize in new writers is that they try to make their style very deliberatable. In other words, they tend to pick a writing style and separate from the topic matters. The end of the result is that both in style and expressive are weakened. Once Yuri finds her train of thought, it's been demeanor totally changes. Her stammering is completely gone and sounds like an expert. Alright. Of course, it's not something you can blame for. There are many different skills and techniques that go into writing even a simple poem. Not just finding them and building them, but getting them to work together is probably the most challenging part. It might take you some time, but it all comes with practice and learning by example, training new things. I also hope that everyone else in the club keeps you valuable. Okay, let's just order. Natsuki can be a little bit biased though. How? Well, never mind. I shouldn't be talking about people like that. Sorry. It's fine. I'm not sure if you're apologizing to herself, or to me, or to Natsuki. Do you mind if I read your poem now?
Please do! I'd love to share my thought process behind it.
Yuri smiles dreamily as if it's a rare opportunity for her. Which itself is kind of funny. Okay. After all, it's supposed to be a literature club. Alright. Ghost Thunder. What the fuck? I haven't even read it yet. God fucking damn it. I have to load it again. Fuck. God damn it. Fucking shit. Bullshit. I gotta read it again. Fucking annoying. Yeah, shit. Fucking shit. Fucking moron. I'm so fucking annoying. God fucking damn it. Shit. I'm bullshit. I gotta judge him. So fucking annoying. Fucking read it again, just for sure. Fucking chicka motherfucking jiggle jiggle shit. Jiggle puff fucking shit. I got your money, my name is Jeff. Okay. Alright, back here. Ghost under the light. The testicles? Oh man, no. The tendrils of my hair illuminate beneath the amber glow, battling
It must be this one, the last remaining streetlight to have withstood the test of time, the last yet to be replaced by a sickening blue-green hue of the future. I bathe, calm, breathing air of the present but living in the past. The light thickens.
What?
Oh, the light flickers. Fuck. I flicker back.
Okay. Alright, hold on.
I'm sorry, I'm such a terrible handwriting.
Yeah. What?
I wasn't thinking that at all. I was thinking it though. But it looks like you took a long time to read. Okay. Well, I just don't read scripts very often.
I actually think your handwriting is pretty.
Flaring guy. Eh? That's a relief.
Alright, always so slow. I also like the poem. Even though it's short, it was really descriptive.
It wasn't too short. I usually write longer poems.
Not at all.
I'm really glad you like it. I'll be honest, since it's our first time sharing, I want to write something a little more mild. Something easy to digest, I guess.
Are you into ghost theory? Okay. Alright. Actually, this story isn't about a ghost at all, Chidi.
Really?
I must have totally missed the point.
Well, I suppose you did only glance over it after all. But remember, the poets often express their own thoughts, feelings, and experience in their work.
They usually do more, tell a simple story, or paint a picture. In this case, perhaps the subject of the poem is the only being symbolically compared to a ghost, lingering in her past remaining place in a comfort, unable to let go of the past and soon to be left with nothing.
That's more of solemn putting it that way. I haven't really even thought about that. That's impressive. It's nothing really. Well, it makes me happy that you think that. Just remember that it won't be long before you pick on these things too.
Yeah, maybe you're right. I guess I'll have to keep trying.
I'm counting on you.
Okay. Now we go for Natsuki. Okay. Alright.
Okay, well, let's start with the things I don't like. First of all,
Natsuki reads my poem.
Never mind, I don't feel like giving you my opinion.
Yeah, what's the point of sharing in this first place? Okay.
I wrote this when I could have been doing the other things. In fact, remember how I said I wanted to read your poems? That's what I had in mind when writing this. I want you to feel comfortable enough to share yours, like Monica said.
I would probably be more comfortable sharing my poem if yours was really bad. You were supposed to show me some dumb poem and make me go,
well, it's not that great, but let me show you what real literature looks like. And you went and ruined it. I hope you're happy.
So in other words, you're saying you like it? Natsuki resorts, gets caught in her throat.
You just don't understand anything, do you?
I really told you don't have to go announcing it to the world like you're all self-important, because you never actually said that. I said it mostly to myself, not really. Nah, you must really hate me or something. I can figure it out if it's a win or a loss. That's like my poem. In any case, you still need to show me yours, right?
Grrr. Fine, I guess.
Only because Monica will make me if I don't. Eagles can fly, monkeys can climb, crickets can live, horses can race, owls can see, cheetahs can run, eagles can fly, people can try, but that's about it. Okay. Pretty good. Yeah, I told you that you weren't gonna like. Flirting? What? Just be honest, I am. Why are you so convinced that you don't like it? Well,
because everyone in high school thinks that handwriting has to be sophisticated and stuff, so people can don't even take my handwriting seriously. But isn't the point of poems for people to express themselves? Your handwriting style shouldn't be make your message less valid. Yes, exactly. I like it when it's easy to read, but it hits you hard. Like in this poem, seeing everyone around you do great things can be really disheartening. So I decided to write a poem about it. Yeah, I understand, but the other things about simple writing is that it puts more weight into wordplay. Like I set up for the rhyme at the end, but then made it flow flat on purpose. It helped me bring out last night, so you did. I guess more we went more into it than I realized. That's what it means to be a pro. Legendary. I'm glad you learned something I didn't expect from the youngest one here today. Yeah, guess not. I decided to humor her with the lads. Come, I don't really care how old everyone is, but if not the case feeling proud, then I won't think that. Alright. Last one. Sayori, my childhood friend. Okay. Oh my goodness! This is so good, Cheesy. I love it. I had no idea you were such a good writer.
Sayori, you must be seriously overreacting. I'm not a good writer at all.
I honestly have no idea what I'm doing. Well, maybe that's why. Because I have no idea what I like.
This is so weird. This is some weird girl, okay? Jeez. Your opinion was more constructive than this. Are you sure you don't like just because I wrote it?
Well, I'm sure that's part of it.
I think I understand you better than a lot of other people, you know. So when I read your poem, it's not just a poem. It's a GD poem. Oh, come on. And that makes it feel extra special. Like I can feel your feelings in it. Sayori hugs the shit against in her chest. Okay. You're so weird, Sayori. I'm really happy that you wrote me one. Reminds me of how really part of the club, you know? Not mention the fact that I'm standing in front of you in the club room. Well, of course, I'm not really into it yet, but doesn't mean I'm breaking my promise. See? It's like I said before, G, deep down you're not selfish at all, you know? Trying new things like this for other people, that's something only really good people do. Thanks, Sayori. I'm not sure if Sayori sees the full picture of my motive here. Then again, I can't deny that she's part of the reason I joined. Know how much this means to her and all. Yeah, I'm gonna make sure you have lots of fun here, okay? That will be my way of thanking you. Alright, I'm going to hold you onto that then.
Yay! And now you read my poem too, right? Don't worry, I'm really bad at it.
We'll see about that. Dear sunshine, the way you glow through my blinds in the morning, it makes me feel like you missed me. Kissing my forehead to me, to help me out of my bed, making me rub the sleepy from my eyes. Are you asking me to come out and play? Are you trusting me to wish away a rainy day? I look above, the sky is blue. It's a secret, but I trust you too. If it wasn't for you, I could sleep forever. But I'm not mad, I want breakfast. Was the ending really necessary? Okay. Sayori, this is just a guess, but did you wait until this morning to write this?
No, just a little bit.
You can answer just a little bit to a yes or no question. I forgot to do it last night. Well, at least that makes sense. That makes me feel a little better about myself.
Don't be mean. I still tried my best.
Yeah. I didn't mean to say it was a bad poem. It came out very nice, actually. Or how should I put it? It sounds just like you.
Really?
Yeah. Especially that last line.
I made eggs and toast. Even though you were late to school, it's bad to skip breakfast. I get all cranky.
Well, I guess there's no point in arguing. Anyway, thanks for showing me.
Ehehe.
This was so much fun. Monica's the best. Yeah, Monica's the best. But next time, won't forget. Okay? Remember? Well, I guess I look forward to it. Alright. Pew! I guess that's everyone. A glance around the room that was a little more stressful than I anticipated. It's as if everyone is judging me for my Medicore writing abilities. Even if they're just being nice, there's no way my poems can stand up to theirs. This is Literature Club after all. I sigh. I guess that's what I ended up getting myself into. Across the room, so you are in Monica happily chatting. My eyes landed on Yuri and Natsuki. They gingerly exchange sheets of paper, sharing their perspective poem. As they read in tandem, I watch them, their expression change. Natsuki's eyebrows furrow in frustration. Meanwhile, Yuri smiles sadly. What's with that language?
Eh? Did you say something?
It's nothing. Natsuki dismissively returns to the poem to the desk with one hand. I guess you could say it's fancy.
Ah, thanks. Yours is good.
Cute? Did you completely miss the symbolism or something? It's clearly about feelings of giving up. How can you that be good?
I know that. I just meant the language, I guess. I was trying to say something nice.
Eh? You mean you have to try that card to come up with something nice to say?
Thanks, but it really doesn't come up nice at all.
Okay, this is getting pretty bad.
If I was looking for suggestion, I would have asked someone who actually liked it, which people did, by the way. Sayori liked it. And GD did it too. So based on that, I'll gladly give you my suggestion of my own first of all. Excuse me, I appreciate the offer, but I've spent a long time establishing my writing style. I didn't expect it to change.
Okay, this is getting better. Which I haven't. And GD liked my poem too, you know. He even told me he was impressed by it, Natsuki-san. Oh no. I didn't realize you were such invested. I'm trying to impress our new member, Yuri. Okay, the sound stuff.
Eh?
Okay.
That's not what I, you're just...
Yuri stands up as well.
Maybe you're just a little jealous that she appreciates my advice more than I appreciated you.
Huh?
And how do you know? He didn't even appreciate my advice more? Are you that full of yourself? If I was full of myself, I would deliberately go out in my way to make everything I do more cute. So,
is everyone okay?
Well, you know what? I wasn't the one whose boobs magically grew
her size and as soon as GD started showing up. Oh my
God! Natsuki.
Natsuki, that's a little...
This doesn't involve you.
Oh, my poor Monica. I don't like fighting guys. Suddenly both girls turns towards me as if they just know me. I was standing there.
GD, she's just trying to make me look bad. That's not true. She started it. If she could...
Alright. Then this...
First place, what's the point of making your poems all convoluted for no reason? Their meaning, you should jump out. Help me explain it then, and I do it. Wait, And there's a reason we have so many deep and expressive words in our own language. It's the only way to convey complex feelings and meaning to them most effectively. Avoiding them is not only necessary to limit yourself, it's also a waste. You understand that, right, Chidi? How did I get dragged at this first place anyway? It's not like I know anything about writing, but whomever I agree with, they'll probably think the more know.
Alright. Who should I choose? Well,
okay, and between these two,
well, she grew a boob for me, so Yuri. Come on. She grew boobs for me, okay? She magically grew boobs when I came. So let's just hear it.
Natsuki, you're right that I like your poem. See? Wait, that's not an excuse for me to be so mean. But Yuri accidentally grew her boobs for me, okay?
Okay?
Yuri wouldn't even take my poem seriously.
I understand, Yuri.
Yeah? You're a silly, talented writer. It's no secret that I was impressed. Well, that's... But there's the thing. No matter how simple or refined something's writing style is, there's still putting feelings into it and becomes... That's why Natsuki felt threatened when you said her poem was good. See? I didn't notice that. I'm sorry. Oh. But Natsuki... You took it way too far. Yuri means well, and you just told her how you felt, and this wouldn't have happened in the first place. Are you kidding? That's exactly what I did. It was her that... Natsuki, I think that's enough. You both said it. You didn't mean, Yuri apologized, don't you? Natsuki clenches her fist. In the end, nobody has taken her side. She's trapped at this point, being defined only because she can't handle the pressure. I ended up feeling bad for her. Sometimes when I'm hurt, I don't hear my head say, or if she doesn't need to, you know what? I'm going to do that. It'll spare me for having to long face. Right? Without warning, Natsuki snatches her own poem desk.
Ah, now I feel fucking bad. Wait. Fuck. I didn't save that. God fucking damn it, I have to redo it all again, okay.
Natsuki, surely didn't need to do that.
Look across the room here.
Yuri has her chin buried in her hands while she stares down at her desk. I gingerly approach her and sit in Jasmine's chair, saying, everything alright? I'm so embarrassed, I can't believe I acted like that, you probably hate me now. No, Yuri, how could anyone... How could I hate anyone who grows their breasts
magical?
You handled it as well as anyone could. I don't think any less of you. Well, alright, I believe you. Thanks, Edie, you're too kind. I'm thankful to have the part. It's nothing. One more thing. That one thing that Natsuki said about... You know, I would never do anything so shameful, so...
What thing did Natsuki say?
Well, never mind then. I'm going to make some tea. Ah, good idea. Make enough for more than one person, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, everyone. It's just about time for us to leave. How did you all finish sharing poems? It was a lot of fun. Well, I'd say it was worth it. It was alright. Well, mostly. GD, how about you? I'd say the same. It was a neat thing to talk about with everyone. Awesome. In that case, we'll do the same thing tomorrow, okay? And maybe you learn something too from your friends too. Alright, so your poems will turn out even better. I think to myself, I did learn more about the kinds of poems everyone likes. With any luck, that means I can at least do a better job impressing those I want to impress. I'm not with my newfound determination. GD, ready to walk home? Sure, let's go. I'm sorry, Ayori beams me. It's truly has been a while since Ayori and I have spent this much time together. I can really say I'm not enjoying it either. Alright, Sayori.
about what happened earlier. What do you mean, you know, between you and us? Does that thing can happen often? No, that's really the first time I've seen them fighting like that. Okay, so I'm the fault of the thing, okay. Alright, I feel so bad. You don't hate them, do you? No, I don't hate them. I just wanted your opinion, that's all. I can see why they make good friends with you. Phew. You know, GD, it's nice to get Stan with you in the club. But I think seeing you get along with everyone is what makes me the happiest. And I think everyone really likes you too. That's... every day is going to be so much fun, Sai. It looks like Sayora has some karma in the kind of situation I'm in. Sure, being friends with everyone is nice, but doesn't really need to stop there. Well, I just have to see what the future holds, Sayori. I pat Sayori in the shoulder. I said that more to myself than to her, but it's really see to you, Sayori, as an internal monologue sometimes.
Okay, yeah, let's do this.
Okay, I guess I have to choose again. Alright guys, I guess I have to end this episode there, and hopefully you enjoy my video this time, okay? See you next episode!